Hey guys, welcome back to another Tech Guru video. Today we're in Adobe After Effects CS6. We're going to continue our beginner tutorial within After Effects. Today we're going to take a look at basic animation within Adobe After Effects. Animation is a core component of After Effects, and you're really going to want to master this in order to become a great user of After Effects. So the first thing you want to do is go up to Composition and create a new composition. Go ahead and set up, you know, whatever you want your background color to be. Set the width and height. I've already done that on mine, so I'm not going to do that now. Once we have done that, I want you to draw out a shape like I have here. I have drawn out a star shape, and in order to do that, you can go up to your toolbar here, and you have some preset shapes here. You have a rectangle, rounded rectangle, and much more there that you can play around with. Once you have your shape drawn out on the canvas, I want you to go down to your toolbar here. I'm sorry, down here to the timeline, and then you're going to see your shape layer. It should be called Shape Layer 1. I want you to go ahead and go down to Transform, and then I want you to click on that down arrow. All of these different settings here are different settings you can adjust and play with to add animation or movement to your object. This is going to change the core component of that basic object. So, the first thing you want to do is I want to play with position, okay? Now, position is going to allow us to animate our object from one point on the canvas to another. So in order to do that, we're going to want to click on the little stopwatch here right beside position. Click on that now. If you go over to your timeline, you will see a kind of diamond-looking shape here on your timeline. That is called a keyframe, okay? Now, what we want to do is add another keyframe on out on the timeline to make that object move. So go ahead and leave the object where you want it to begin on the canvas, and then go ahead and drag your playhead or current time indicator, which is this thing right here, onto about 4 to 5 seconds. I'm going to drag mine to right around 5 seconds. Now we're going to want to add another keyframe. So in order to do that, all you have to do is grab your selection tool from your toolbar, go up to your canvas, and then drag the object where you want it to end up. So in my case, I'm going to drag it all the way up to the other corner, just like that. Now, I want to see if that is exactly what I wanted to do, so I'm going to take my playhead or current time indicator and drag it all the way back to the beginning keyframe. Now, in order to play your animation or to play what you had just created, all you have to do is press the space bar on your computer. Now, as you see, the star shape has moved from the beginning keyframe to the ending keyframe, which is up here. Again, all you have to do is click on the stopwatch here beside the setting that you want to adjust. Now that we've adjusted the position, we're going to go down and adjust the scale of the object. Now, the scale of the object is how big the object is. So, just like we did with the previous setting, we want to drag our playhead all the way to the beginning keyframe, click on the stopwatch beside scale, just like so. That creates another keyframe. Then we want to drag our playhead all the way out to 5 seconds, just like that. And now, in order to create another keyframe, all we have to do is adjust the scale, just like this here. So, I'm going to take my scale on this keyframe. I'm going to make my object smaller. I'm going to make it about that small. And then I'm going to drag it over just right here. Now, remember, in order to adjust the keyframe that you're on, you need to make sure that you're on the correct keyframe, all right? So let's go ahead and drag our current time indicator back to the beginning of the timeline. Now, if we press the space bar, not only will our object move from one location to another on the canvas, but it will also go from being a bigger object to a smaller object, all because we're adjusting the scale. Now, I'm not going to go through each and every one of these settings or else this video would drag out. I'm going to explain them and you can play around with those for yourself. The first one that you see here is the anchor point. What that is pretty much where your object is located on the canvas. So instead of going and dragging the object around the canvas, you can actually set an exact anchor point from this position. The next one is the rotation. Now, what this does is allows you to rotate your image. So it allows you to start the image at a certain rotation and then end it at another. So if you look here, it says 0x plus 0.0 degrees. If I change this 0x to 1x and then change this here to, let's say, 30 degrees, what it's going to do is it's going to rotate that object one time 30 degrees. Okay? That's how you use the rotation setting. Next is our opacity setting. The opacity setting is fairly self-explanatory. This is going to take your object on the starting keyframe and then take whatever setting you set the opacity to. It will change the opacity when it ends on that keyframe. So guys, this has been a very basic understanding of how to use animation within Adobe After Effects. If you have any questions, go ahead and put those in the comment box below. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching my videos. It does mean a lot. Keep an eye out for the other videos in this series. This is the beginner After Effects series. I'll put the links down in the description box below. If this video helped you, go ahead and like this video, share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more great content just like this. And guys, I will see you next time. We'll be right back.